Hello, this is my face today. Goodness gracious. I dressed up for the occasion. It works, I suppose. It's Celtic. I'll take it. I better. So I think we got to about just over halfway through this. So I'm thinking we finish this and then where's this? So we have 2 hours or 3 hours. We got 3 hours to finish the replay, which I think will be plenty of time. I think. Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, has. Oh, yeah, this one.
The Northmen say that their all-father, Odin, gave his eye in exchange for a drink from Mimir's well, the Well of Wisdom. In blindness, there can be wisdom. Only by giving can you receive in return. For this reason, I give my life and pass on my stories of the Northmen to you, Senua.
Yeah, so good.
Where am I?
Can you hear me? I'm right here. Can't you see me?
Help me.
Breathe slow.
It's the darkness.
Stay still. Empty your thoughts. Tell me what you feel.
A breeze.
Good. Then there is a way out.
I can't tell where it comes from.
Yes, you can.
Can I? Fuck that. I'm scared of the dark. I think it's because, like, so much negative is associated with dark. Well, I think it more so is my fear of the unknown. Actually.
The others. The voices. They've gone.
I'm still here.
It's so quiet. So dark.
Okay, listen to your own breath. Feel it rise and fall. Good. Be aware of everything you hear and feel. Let your senses guide you.
We want an insta-band. Fuck that.
I can't go on. Lillian?
Find a way. I'm not leaving you here.
Meet away, wind chimes.
I think I'm somewhere else now. But the breeze has gone.
Use all of your senses. Let the world speak to you. What do you hear?
I hear water.
Go to it.
Reach the water.
Good. That's your way out. Follow it upstream.
I'm so sorry. I thought I left this all behind.
Don't be sorry. It's not your fault.
He was right. It's inside of me. It won't let me go.
Senua. My father. He taught me that the hardest battles are fought in the mind, not the sword.
Ain't that the truth?
You're no coward. Prove that to me in the warrior trials. This is just another battle. You can beat it.
This isn't your battle. You don't have to help him.
I want to. Besides, you are going to be a great warrior one day. We need people like you.
Okay. I'll do my best.
Shh. Shh. I know what you're thinking. It's not really you. It seems there's no escaping the past in this place. She's forced to relive it. To what end?
There is a house.
See it?
No.
Then it cannot see you. Quietly move past it. One step at a time.
That was not quiet. I have my eyesight back, please. I don't like this.
It's not following me.
Leave it behind and keep moving forward.
course I slept.
There's more of them. I've been done moving.
You're breathing too fast.
I'm scared.
Listen to the sound of the breath.
Ah!
In and out. In and out.
No, I hate it.
Do this, Senua.
I hate these things. The noises they make either. Disturbing. Get me out. No worries. That's the thing when I play games like that are newly released as well. Well, not this one, but the bad thing about it is that majority of the time I don't have an audience because everyone else is playing it. That's the problem when you have like a community of like-minded people. So I expect it'll be really quiet today. That's okay.
I think I'm in a house. It stinks of death.
The darkness is testing you. Control.
Yeah, this is the first time I've played like a day one. I'll be playing a day one release for a while. Like, yeah. Usually I end up playing them off stream. That's what I've been doing lately. Like, I did that with Ragnarok. So I just didn't want anyone to spoil it too. You're right, Renok. The voice is in my head. Thanks, Buck. Have a good night.
A well. There's a well.
Don't turn back. You're getting close.
Jump in. Oh, great.
Please. Help me. Please.
Come to us.
Ew, 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 ew. Be assuming you're a 9-to-5er. I don't know, that's a big assumption. You'll be playing it pretty much from release. It's all bright.
She could spend hours, days even, trapped within herself, in the dark.
Coffee.
You see me?
Yes.
Your eyes were open, but you were gone.
And when it finally let her go, she could be anywhere, with no memory of how she got there.
When it comes for me, I have no power over it.
But here, for the first time, someone was there to help.
But I heard your voice. You brought me back.
You found your own way back. All you needed was a little help. A little hope.
You like her or not? And for 10 hours? What do you do?
What if this is close? What if you're wrong?
You've been fooled before, you could be fooled again.
You're being tested.
You don't know. It's just their game for you. You never know which way it's going to go.
Shut up, Renok. Not everyone works a 10-hour shift. Jesus. 10-hour shifts, that's long. Very long. Nothing. 10-hour shift doing nothing is worse. Right. There was a period of time when I was dental nursing. I think I've gone the wrong way, by the way. And there was like a big because I used to work in a private clinic as well, so and there was a big like empty gray area where there weren't any sort of schemes where people just couldn't afford to go to the dentist, and we would just have day upon day upon day of no patients, and someone still had to sit there, and it was always me. I'd always get stuck in it. I hated it. It's fun at first, right? Because you're like, woo, don't have to work, woo, but your days go so slow and it just becomes so monotonous. I hated it. Rather work. We're not ready to get the sword yet. We've got one more to do, don't we? Did I go the wrong way? Maybe I can get to it this. Dang. You working with some confidential stuff. They said no camera phones, so you don't take photos.
A king in the north forced the dwarves to make a sword that would never fail and never rust, and that would slice through iron and stone and bring victory to its bearer. But the angry dwarves cursed it. It would be the death of a man every time it was drawn, and it would be the death of the king. Let me tell you about the sword Tyrving.
I don't recognize this place. Where are we? Where is she?
It feels wrong.
Where are we now? Burial mound. So strange that we go to such lengths to bury death. Something so very ordinary. inevitable. It's as if we conspire to hide death, because we have no answer for it. But when it comes and forces itself onto our friends or loved ones, then comes the reckoning.
Man, the writing on this game too is just so good. Like, lines like that. So good. Subs or carriers? Viper. Oh, we're up to the part that we... Because when we hosted Rocker last night, this is what she was up to.
Trials, like when we first met, remember?
I'm working on it.
I'll find him.
Senua, you remind me of a story that the Northmen tell about a young woman warrior. Her name is Hervor, the daughter of a berserker, born after he was killed. She's a wild, willful child who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword, Tyrving.
The voice is getting louder. Listen,
Dillian.
Listen, listen, listen. It's here. Listen. It's getting louder.
There he is.
You're getting this.
Keep going.
Senua, follow the voice.
You're nearly there.
Dillian's voice.
It's him. He's going to save you.
Find the voice.
Find him.
It's not him. It's not him.
We told you. We told you it was a trick.
It's not Dillian.
You have to find another way.
There has to be another way.
You don't recognize it.
Don't doubt yourself. You'll never find it.
She doesn't recognize it.
Yes, you do. You know where you are.
She doesn't.
Listen for his voice. Listen.
Dillian? Where
yes,
are you?
They look the same.
Looks the same. Something's different.
Look for clues.
What is it?
What's different?
There's a clue.
Look.
Is it a shield? Shields are different. Maybe I have to head towards the different. Oh, this is different. I know we went that way. Go the other way.
Hervor disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors, and soon becomes their leader. When they come to the island where her father is buried, her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless, she lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires as though they were mist. The flames I passed through were real enough. Damn the Northmen to hell.
Thanks, Feta. Have a good sleep. Ew, I don't like that. Please stop.
You're lost forever.
What are you gonna do when the torch runs out?
You'll wander around until it gets dark, and then what will you do?
Then will you save yourself?
This will come to claim you again.
Nothing you can do. Nothing.
I'm going around in circles, actually. These aren't changing. I must have missed something. Anything with these, though. But these are all dead ends. All right, I'm missing something. What am I missing? Go backwards. Listen to this one?
Senua, you remind me of a story that the Northmen tell about a young woman warrior. Her name is Herver, the daughter of a berserker, born after he was killed. She's a wild, willful child who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword, Tyrving.
This is where I'm hitting dead end. I've done the exact same thing, haven't I? Yeah, dead end, and then there's a dead end around there too. Well, shit. Well, shit. Yep. That about sums it up. Wibble wobble. I'm confused. Yeah, they're not even giving me hints anymore. I think I got it.
I'm leaving. I've decided. I think it will be good for me.
It's the darkness. It's speaking through.
No, Dad, it's me. I think I can beat it in my own way.
I can see the darkness in your eyes, child.
I met a boy.
Boy.
The chief fencer.
No.
He said he could help me.
It's a trick.
He said I could be normal.
Normal?
Yes.
IGT.
No boy is going to save you. No one can. When they see the rot growing inside you,
no.
They will turn their back on you. The gods can only fix you through my hand. You're going nowhere.
No.
You will not defy the gods. Come, child, take my hand. Come, Senua.
No! I am leaving!
You cannot escape the darkness. Your curse will make everyone suffer. You will have blood on your hands!
Killing you would be too easy. They're taking your memories to torture you.
Joke's on you, Dad! I'm defying and fighting gods.
Everything. They're not yours anymore. They're gonna take everything you have. The memories of ghosts.
I have to answer this call.
They're
one sec.
Eating you from the inside. They want to kill your soul. They want to crush it. You think they want your body? They want your soul. They want your mind, and they're going to take it. The memories were yours, but they're the gods now. Nothing is yours anymore. Dillian's disappearing with your memories.
Thank you. Okay, sorry. It's my landlord. I had to take that. Okay. Get back in my ear. Alright, voices in my head secured. Let's get this sword. I think we've done them all now, haven't we?
Gillian gave her the strength to pass the warrior trials, and she saw a way out. To leave her past behind and become a warrior in Dillian's clan.
The sword is tainted by the gods of darkness. Leave it.
No. He left it here. He wants me to take it.
You will pay a price for this.
But years later, with Zinbal's parting words still haunting her, the darkness came back with a vengeance.
Yeah, everything's okay. It's just some maintenance stuff.
A plague.
Don't you?
Let me write that down.
Okay. Everyone suffered.
My father was not supposed to die like this.
Do you see it clearly now, Senua? The suffering you've caused.
This is your fault. You brought this plague to us! You have blood on your hands!
Wasn't me.
They're coming for you now.
They're coming.
They're coming to get you.
Okay.
Hold your heavy strike. Hold it. Hold the heavy strike. Hold your heavy strike. Unleash the sword.
Let's dance. Oh, go.
Focus is coming back. How did it focus?
Waved through itself over the ones I loved. The ship broke up under them. The ship that had sailed from a land of shining fields. Their memorial stone a secret. Come not here in the sun. Come not with a sword. Come not crying over a naked corpse. Come not with disturbed mind.
Suffering, Senua. Does your precious gift of sight let you see the souls that rot here in this sea of corpses? Do you feel the blood running cold on your skin? Do you hear their endless cries? Do you smell their putrid wounds? They were once brothers, sisters, and loved ones. And look at what you have done to them. All because you were a coward, because you ran from your curse instead of facing it. When you turned your back on your father, Zinbal, you turned your back on the gods and let the darkness wreak havoc on your people. Why must they pay for your heresy?
Bruh. my mirror to touch. Oh shit. Ah, I'm backed in a corner. I don't like this. I can't move. Hacks. Oh, there's more. Oh god, he's a big boy. Hello. Ah! Ah!
Quickly get up!
Get up!
She's injured. She's not gonna make it. Watch out! Oh, move over and over again. But it's working! Oh, it's dirty. You're close. He's finished.
Oh, that was dirty!
Who is it? Galina?
Calls for you, Senua. Go to her. Answer her pitiful call.
Mom!
The darkness took her life and it will take yours. It's taking you. Taking you further and further into it. Into the darkness.
The only way she knew how. She gave her life to the gods. had done the same, the world would have been spared this horror. It's not too late. She's calling for you. Why don't you join her?
Oh, wait, again. There's an easier way.
He can breathe.
What the? Ah! hard. Did I die? Oh shit, I did so well! Oh my god, that's only like the second time I've died. Damn it. Not so far. We go again.
Why brethren in this rot and let your blood seep into the seas and the rivers of hell. Isn't that what you deserve after all you've done? Give the darkness what it wants, let it swallow your soul and destroy all that you are. Why are you fighting for someone who is already dead? Just look around.
Is the guy who does this voice, sorry, I know that was very sudden, is it the same voice actor that does Sid in Final Fantasy 16 and the guy in Diablo 4? What's his name? Hang on. I'm gonna Google it. I've forgotten his name. English fellow. Because he has such a great voice. That's his name, Ralph Ineson. Did you do this voice, mister? Oh, it's not him? Yeah, not Senua. Like, her dad. With this voice. It sounds like him. It's not him? Chippo Chung? Yeah. I think it's Stephen Hartley, actually. This isn't the narrator, this is, like, the voice of her dad. I think they're separate. Great voice, nonetheless. That was my, moral of the story.
What hope is there for him, even if his soul could be rescued? You think he'll thank you for what you have done to him, to his friends, to his father?
Close.
He's down. Finish it. Finish it.
I'm not a fan, Haikwa. I'm not much of a fan of the movie or series, so I don't really have a comment on that. I just know he's got a great voice. But I go backwards. Oh, did I go all the way back to the beginning? Oh. Silly me.
Gave up on her world to follow in the footsteps of her mother, to go to a place where the darkness couldn't reach her.
Senua, look at me.
Do you hear them? Calling for me.
We've lost so many. And I've lost my father. I can't lose you.
You said it. I have blood on my hands.
I didn't say that. You've done nothing wrong.
Zimbal was right. Everyone will suffer.
Zimbal is a fake. He is a hateful, bitter liar. He's poison. And his words still haunt you. Who do you trust? Him? Or me? Do you still believe in me, Senua? In us? Come back to me. Please. Don't let this darkness come between us.
Sword with which to fight in more ways than one. And she gave him her word, never to surrender. All she needed was a little help, a little hope.
Nice for once, I'm listening.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf, Reyn. But Reyn does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Reyn's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Reyn's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
A dragon. A dragon. Hello, Heathy. How's it going? Thank you. Thank you, pretty. Thank you.
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
No, go in. Don't. Turn back. Turn back.
What's it like?
Get back. A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name. And it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How will you save Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadows?
They can't stop me.
Then do it.
I'm doing it.
The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Okay. Gonna make a run for it.
Run!
It's locked.
Don't be fooled. The beast is still here. No. It's a trick.
She knows that. Does she? What is that voice?
Mother, do you hear that?
Don't fall for it.
It's me, Senua.
It's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate.
It's a trap.
I just want to help them. Tell me what to do. Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them.
But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
they want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen.
Do you
to them.
See them? Do you see their faces?
He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
She'll have to go on.
She can't.
She has to.
She can't.
The torch will go out.
No.
Go out. She can do it.
And I have to.
The light's gone out.
Run!
Run! Run! Get through it as quick as you can. The panic is here.
What was that? Right. And go.
So.
But he's I see that one.
Where is it, you? Hidden in plain sight. She has it. You have it. Keep going. Where's the next? Two more to find. I can feel the two more to find. Why are you doing these pointless rules? Symbols are pointless. They're meaningless. Your mother's here. What if you connect them and there's nothing behind the door? Save Dillia.
Got one. Oh shit, that's gonna go off 10 times, isn't it? I didn't fix that alert. Oh no. Thank you! And sorry! Senua. So much. We're almost at that sub goal. Can't like that one. I don't think I'm supposed to go that way. That's like right at the beginning. Okay. Instead of down.
Her torch is going out. No, it's not going to run out soon.
She has to say that.
Burn out. She's too slow. It's not going to burn out. The darkness will come again.
Thank you. There.
She has it.
She did it. She's done it.
Well done.
This place. It reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room. The faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? That there are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
The fucker. Did it.
You can't go anywhere without your light. Take the torch and move. Blood.
Let the torches.
Did I? I don't remember.
Until I open my mouth. Thank you, I appreciate it.
She escaped the darkness. That she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
Sealed. Now it can see you at your weakest. The time you suffered as a child at the hands of your father, Zimbo, when you pined for Dillion. Do you remember the darkness, Senua?
It's a replay.
The beast is bringing it back.
Did you leave me?
You for the follow?
This darkness. It's spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dillion.
Damn straight! We gotta go find our mans. Alright, I'm just gonna go get some water. One moment, I will be right back. Aye. Okay.
So.
You killed us.
way. Oh! Oh, great. Shieldy boy. Ow! Bro, how did I never know about that heavy attack? Christ, forgot about that. That almost ended badly. Okay. No, that's backwards. Oh, we have to go on the other side, don't we? And look at it.
Her father tried to help her, but she wouldn't listen. He was doing his best. She never, ever listens.
Why didn't she listen to him? Trying to help her. He was trying to save her from the darkness. Zinbel was trying to save her from the darkness.
Lies!
Has Dillian's soul.
And it will take it and never give it back.
She can search and search, but she will never find.
She's let the darkness in. It's the end.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
Pointless
even trying to retrieve it.
Go look at the door first.
She's lost.
Where is she going? She's got to go deeper to find the head.
Rian the dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rian would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rian reforges the thing's sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rian go in search of Fafnir.
There's a limit. We don't go that way. What have you been up to, Rabbit? Here and light, yeah, there's.
What's she doing?
She's lighting the fire.
She's making light. She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
Now I know.
What's her plan? What's she thinking? How's she going to get there?
now. I can do this.
Now she can. She can do it.
Wee!
Stop! She has to do it! Get up! Get up! What are you doing?
Big brain. Why is this not working? Well, I have to look at this door again.
Nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of Orr, who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
It's not entirely wrong. Please don't touch me. It'd be worse.
Nay, nay! darkness!
Hear him!
Oh god, I can't see. Just don't die. Doing so well.
Must find him now.
zombies over here.
People think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals, kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness. Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. Maybe Delian would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore.
Shut up. Listen.
But believe this. It was my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. Free about it.
Listen.
I fear you would let those fly. All this time, I've wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
And take me to the mountains, trust me, as deep as we can go.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him.
You will not survive what is in there.
I know.
Trick me again. I know you're safe with the gods. I can feel Hela's gaze searching for secrets inside of me. Secrets that even I can't see. I'm not here to fight my past. I'm here for Dillian.
I will fulfill my vow, whatever the cost.
Say the world will come to an end. They call this Ragnarok, the destiny of the gods. First, there will be a terrible winter, 3 years long. Then, mankind will turn on itself. Brothers will fight each other to the death, and people will forget what they owe their kindred. Times will be hard. Crimes will be great. It will be an age of axes and swords. The wind will blow through abandoned halls. Wolves will walk where children played. The world will fall into ruin.
Sounds like a real hoot. One part. Get over on the other side now. Hi, Lad. Push. Oh. Got him. come from?
What will she do?
Oh, wait.
How's she going to find his actual self?
Yeah. We go back.
No.
She killed him.
She cannot bargain with Hela. She's not strong enough to kill Hela. What does Hela want? No one can bargain with Hela.
What does Hela want? What can she give her?
If she could give her her own soul.
No.
Something rotting.
She'd rather die. Oh.
It's a worthless soul. But it's all she has to give.
She has a warrior soul. Cursed soul.
Of course she is, no matter what she does. She can fight her. She can fight her at Ragnarok.
She's a warrior. She's come this far.
Hela will want to fight her.
Strong.
She can see it.
The bridge.
She can't cross the bridge.
It's broken. She has to fix it.
It's too dangerous.
She's done it before. You have to fight her. Final battle.
Get his soul back. It's the final task.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
This isn't just a broken bridge, is it? Mother, you showed me how to see further. To see the hidden wonders in our world and explore new paths into the unknown. To lead so that others may follow. Or to warn so that they may avoid. That is our gift and our duty. I'm not going to look away in fear anymore.
How do we get that final part?
The Northmen say the gods will fight their last battle at Ragnarok. Their watchmen will blow the horn that can be heard through the whole world. And Odin will speak with the severed head of Mimir, which gives him good counsel. The land of the giants will thunder with the sound of their army on the move. The gods will assemble. The dwarves will leave their stones. The frost giants will come from the east. The Midgard serpent will churn up the waves. Eagles will scream and tear at the corpses with their yellow beaks. The ship of the dead will set sail.
Ragnarok.
The Northmen say that at Ragnarok, the gods will face a ship full of their foes, which Loki has steered to Asgard. It carries the fire giants, the wolf that will eat the sun, and all kinds of dark creatures. Surt will join them with his sword of fire. The cliffs will crash. Trolls will walk the land. Men will tread the road to hell, and the heavens will split open.
Wait, I can't even open this door. I miss. Oh. That's what. Oh, what?
Nobody can.
Thank you. Jesus. Right, which way did I come in? Oh. Yeah, yeah. Bridge is fixed. I go further up. For a better story.
The Northmen say that each god will do battle at Ragnarok. Odin will fight the monstrous wolf and be killed, but his son will avenge him and plunge his sword into the heart of the beast. Freyr will face Surt, but he had given his sword away for love, and without it, he cannot defend himself against the flames. Thor will smite the Midgard serpent to no avail. The sun will grow black, the earth will sink into the sea, the stars will disappear, fire and water will meet, steam will shoot up, flames will play against the sky, the heavens and earth and all the world will be burned, all the gods will be dead, and the warriors of Valhalla and the people everywhere. Senua, prepare yourself for Ragnarok, for it is nigh.
Wasn't me, I didn't do it. Not even my religion. Not a great start. Tell me that, Jacko. Don't tell me that, because that means I won't be playing today. Because unlike the rest of the world, Australian internet, 40 gig, that's like hours. That's like hours for me. Don't say that, because I did pre-install. No. No. man. That's gonna suck if it is true.
She's getting closer to Hela.
You're playing on Xbox? I don't know if it's gonna be the same on PC.
Wait.
But...
what happens when she dies? Wait.
What?
What happens when she dies? What happens to us? What happens to us?
We die too.
Do we die too?
We
I
die
don't
too.
Want to die. I don't want to die.
We'll all die someday.
I don't want to die.
And when everyone's gone, even the gods will die.
We don't want to die.
I don't want to die.
Senua, stop.
Turn
back.
Stop. Stop her.
Where is she going?
Stop her.
Senua,
stop.
Why would she stop to die? She won't stop. Stop. Stop.
I don't want to die.
I don't want to die. I don't want to die.
I don't want to die.
I'm sorry. I didn't ask you to be a part of me. If you don't want to die with me, then leave me alone.
I don't want to die. Please stop. Please stop. Please stop. Please stop. Please stop.
Please stop.
Please stop.
You'll never come back if you go there.
There is nothing to go back to.
We only have each other now. Don't abandon me.
Everyone suffers. They were right about me.
Listen to me, not them. They are afraid. Like children scared of the dark.
So was I.
They made up monsters to fill the void. That doesn't make them real.
They made them real.
No!
Although I've just been told, Ted, that there's a 40 gig extra to download. So if that's the case, that means I won't even be playing today.
Facing evil in search of victory and honor. Clear dividing lines. No. Oh, this place is not quite like that. It's as if it knows that true torment lies within. Memories you cannot defeat, cannot escape. This is her hell.
Nothing to fear anymore. The gods have saved your mother. Through my hands.
You killed her.
It is the will of the gods.
Fuck the gods! You did this to her! Why?
This is what happens when you listen to the voices of the underworld. They crawl into your soul and rot you from the inside. Defy the gods like your mother, and the darkness will come for you too.
You understand, Senua?
Fuck the gods! Fuck you, Dad!
I do understand. You cursed me with your own madness! I was just a child. You created this darkness! You created this darkness so you could hide behind it!
Oh, hello, Hela.
Only suffering brings salvation.
Creepy bitch.
Is the way of the gods.
Don't look at me like that. Oh, she's so weird.
You are a lie! She didn't defy the gods. She defied you. And so you killed her.
You didn't pray to the gods. You prayed to your mother. Your mother, who was too weak to fight the darkness and abandoned you.
You tortured her. You killed her. You are the darkness.
The years of isolation, the pain that still haunts you. It was the only way to fight the curse within you.
You're a liar.
The darkness is inside you that will destroy you.
You're a liar!
No, Senua. The darkness is here. You can't wish it away. And it will watch as you draw the last dying gasp.
I won't let you kill me! Darkness. You're a liar and a murderer. And if you really are Hela,
then I have a sword here that can kill a god!
Fuck yeah, you tell her.
Look at you. Running forward and moving backwards to one of your miserable past. You're making a mistake searching for Gideon. The same mistake that killed him in the first place. I'm trying to save you from yourself. You said that it is a lie. The plague of darkness, the butchering of the nearby Norsemen. You saw it yourself.
You told everyone I was cursed. They believed you. I believed you.
Tell me, Senua. Where is Gideon's soul if the darkness is a lie? How you saved him?
He's here. I know he's here. Gideon, I know you're here. Hold on. I'll find you.
Back.
again with your lies. I know he's here. You took him from me. You have him.
Gideon is gone.
Give me my man.
Gideon is dead. Let him go now. I'm warning you.
Or what? What can he do to me that you haven't already?
Cavalson,
fight me. Come on.
Watch out.
You betrayed your own father. You betrayed the gods in search of Dillion, in search of love. Look where that's got you. Let go of the battle. Let go of the...
Guys, my standards were already really high. Now it's like, if you ain't fucking fighting Hela and Helheim for my soul, I ain't having it.
Watch out.
If he wanted to, he would. Ow!
Let go of Delia. Let go of your battle. I'm going behind you.
Ah! I died! After all that. Dang. Get up, girlfriend. Get up. Wait, was that supposed to happen?
To me? And to him? You're not a lie, but you're a liar! You crawled into me to confuse me and deceive me. But I know it. I know you have him.
I learned the hard way to not be afraid of death, so... Because a life without loss is one without love. You turn your back on death, and all you can see is the shadow that it casts. The longer you hide from it, the longer the shadow grows until all you can see is darkness. When our time comes, we must look death in the eye and embrace it as a friend. Only then can we let go of our fear. And emerge from our darkness.
Never forget what it is like to see the world as a child, Senua. Every autumn leaf is like a work of art. Every rolling cloud a moving picture. Every day, a new story. We too emerge from this magic, like a wave from the ocean, only to return to the sea. Darkness, the wonder and the beauty of this world never leaves us. It is always there, waiting to be seen again.
This is where my story once began. And so it has to end here. Because I cannot see further than this. Follow us. We have another story to tell.
It's hard to tell how mixed up you feel. How-
Hurts. I don't want you to change. Cause everyone has hopes. You're human after all. The feeling sometimes wishing you were someone else. Feeling as though you never belong. Yes. This feeling is not. Man, I forgot how good this game. Feeling is not joy. I truly understand. Please don't cry now. Please don't go. I want you to stay. Was it your first time playing it? Turn this down a bit now. This was my second, so I played it when it first released, but that was, you know, like 7 years ago. Oh, so good. Randa feels. Being like you are, well, this is something else. Who would comprehend that some that do lay claim divine purpose blesses them? That's not what I believe, and it doesn't matter anyway. A part of your soul ties you to the next world, or maybe to the last, but I'm still not. I'm not sure we can skip this. I don't think we can skip the this. Now comes the scary part where I have a look and see if there is a 40 gig download. Or the sequel, because if there is, that means I can't play today. So much for pre-install. Right in the feels. For all the hurt that you feel, this world is just illusion, always trying to change you. I wanna, like, let's deep dive into it a bit, right? So I'm, and maybe you can fill in the blanks and we can sort of unravel the story and stuff, because there was like a lot of like non-literal things. So like, I'm guessing Senua was mentally ill. So she had psychosis. Her father labeled it as darkness, but she also has a connection to the underworld or the other world. So she could like hear the voices of the dead. But was that just a psychosis or not? But her mother was the same. Shock or horror. Her dad sacrificed the mother in the name of religion, sacrificed her to the gods or whatever. Anyway, but then it seemed like he also, like, tortured Senua as a child in the name of gods and stuff as well. So she labeled it as the darkness, and she kept trying to go on journeys to get rid of it. But then she met Dillion and he, like, taught her ways of coping and stuff, right? Like, I'm just trying to figure out what was literal and what was a roundabout way of explaining it. So I'm guessing the Northmen, like, really came and raided the village and killed Dillion and everyone. I'm guessing that there was a plague and she was blamed for it. Let me know what you think. But what about, like, the whole journey to Helheim and stuff? Was that actually real? So I think she really did believe that if she completed this journey, she'd be able to bring him back. But the journey was actually like a lesson, like a journey for accepting her darkness. But did she really, like, fight gods and giants and Like, yeah, that's the thing, right? Like, is that the point, that we don't know what is real? And what was not, like, what was and what wasn't real? Has someone actually, like, deep dived into this? And, like, written a better explanation? It's more of a journey through grief, yeah. Yeah. And letting go and then moving on and accepting your trauma and that you are the way you are because of your trauma. But, like, yeah, I guess we'll find out more in the sequel. But I'm just trying to think, like, are these gods real? Was Helheim real? Was the Hela real? Is the blade, the god blade real? The god slaying blade? I'm sure someone's done this on Google and like explained it.